You don't need a luxury kitchen to prepare gourmet meals. I wanted a little on the sticky side. With a modest kitchen and some standard equipment, you can cook food that you would be proud to serve. There is my shrimp. All you need is a few helpful kitchen techniques, the ability to follow a recipe, a passion for food, and a fascination with cooking. Just follow along the rib cage.
That is so good.
My name is Dennis. I really do live in a mobile home, in a trailer park, and this is my kitchen. I wanted to do another one of these quick and easy spaghetti dinners because, again, summer is coming and you don't want to spend a lot of time in a hot kitchen. It's good to have some quick recipes that you can get on the table very quickly, but something better than just simply spaghetti with spaghetti sauce from a jar on it. This is a spaghetti with shrimp and a artichoke pesto. It's another restaurant recipe. It's very quick to make. It looks like it's going to be easy. I've got water heating on the stove for my spaghetti. Before my spaghetti cooks, this pesto is going to be ready. So let's start making spaghetti with shrimp and artichoke pesto. I have some prep work to do here, but before I chop up my parsley, I want to show you my artichoke hearts. I have here about 1 cup, 160 grams of artichoke hearts. The artichoke hearts that I buy come packed in water, vinegar, and oil to help get rid of a lot of that vinegar flavor. Last night, I put them in a jar of water, and that will dilute some of that vinegar flavor. But right now, what I need to do is get the leaves off of some Italian or flat leaf parsley. What you need is about a tablespoon of chopped parsley. I have here maybe 6 sprigs, and I probably have more than I need to give me the tablespoon that I want. I'm getting down to the end here of my parsley leaves, and then I want to just give these a quick chop. One of the people who like my videos mentioned that she likes technique more than she likes recipes. So I thought this might be a good idea to explain what a chef's knife is opposed to a lot of other knives. It has a long curved blade, and the idea is you can rock the blade back and forth, and every bit of that cutting edge comes into contact with the cutting board. And that's why a chef's knife is so good for chopping things, because you have the whole blade to work with. If you don't have a good chef's knife, it's a really good investment as far as kitchen tools. This is a 9-inch Henkel's Pro S. And if I remember correctly, at the time they went for about $120. Expensive, but it's I think a good investment. Okay, as I mentioned, I need a tablespoon. And there's my tablespoon of chopped fresh parsley. Another step I need to do here is clean my shrimp. It is already peeled and deveined, but it still has the tail shell on. They do that so that in some recipes, what you want is you want to like fry your shrimp, but the tail is a handle that you can use to, say, dip the shrimp in a sauce. Because I'm going to be eating this shrimp with a fork, I don't need that tail shell on. Okay, so I have all of my shrimp here to do. How much shrimp I have is this recipe is going to feed 4. So I have 16 shrimp here. And these are large shrimp. Check this out. Yes, it's a lemon, but it's got a label on it. I mentioned that because in almost all my videos, when I need lemon, I just walk up to the street. My neighbor's yard has a lemon tree, and she's always telling me, come pick the lemons, because she doesn't use them. And then they fall on the ground and she's got to pick them up. So I take the lemons off of her tree. However, at the moment, there are plenty of lemons on the tree, but they're all green. So for once, I bought my own lemon. I also need to shred some Parmesan cheese. You're going to need about 1/4 cup, maybe 30 grams of freshly grated, freshly shredded Parmesan. Ooh, that smells so good. That's more than 1/4 cup. So what's that? And that should be enough right there. The rest of this I'll put away. And then what I want to do is for garnish at the end, I want to just use a vegetable peeler and shave some flakes of Parmesan that I can use for garnish on top of my dish. Now comes the easy part. Now that all the prep work is done, I can start assembling my sauce. So I'm putting in here a couple of cloves of garlic that I'm going to crush with a garlic press. One more. Okay. There's my garlic in there. And there is my 1 tablespoon of chopped fresh parsley. My 1 cup, 160 grams of artichoke hearts. I drained those from the water that they were in. About 1/4 cup of my Parmesan cheese. I'm going to be grating some more for garnish if I don't want to use those flakes. Then I have my 1 lemon. So I want to squeeze the juice of this 1 lemon into a little bowl here. I try not to get more on the counter than I do in the bowl. And yes, that's a plane going overhead. I do live near the airport. As I like to say, this is a trailer park, not a rich, fancy house out in the Hamptons. And there is my lemon juice. Clean up my mess there. Okay, so that's from 1 lemon. Pinch of salt. Add some freshly ground black pepper to it. You could add other herbs if you like herbs. I'm thinking a little nutmeg might be good in this, but I'm going to go with what I've got. And then about 1/4 cup or a few tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil. Okay. And then, as I like to do, so I have less to clean up, I put a barrier on there before I put my lid on. And then just pulse this to blend it. It doesn't require much. I can chop that a little bit more. I see some larger pieces of artichoke in there. I don't want to reduce it down to a smooth liquid or a puree. I want it to be like a pesto. Oh, and it smells good too. Oh, that smells good. I'm going to give you a close-up of that so you can see what it looks like. So there it is. It's a little chunky, small chunks, kind of like the texture of a pesto. Not too smooth, but you don't want big chunks in there either. That's ready. My water is boiling. My spaghetti is going to go in next. And while that's cooking, I'm going to cook my shrimp. I've got a skillet heating on the stove here, so I'm going to put in about a quarter cup of olive oil and put my shrimp in there. These will cook quickly. You don't want to overcook shrimp because it'll get tough. I've got a shell in there. Okay. So you want to cook these for 2 or 3 minutes till they go pink and they're cooked all the way through. You can see how quickly those are cooking. My shrimp is just about done, so I'm going to put in a few tablespoons of dry white wine. And then I want to reduce that, so I want to get my shrimp out because I don't want to overcook my shrimp. To bring my heat up, and I want to reduce this till most of that liquid is gone. So you can see that most of that liquid now is gone. I want to return my shrimp to the pan, and then I want to put my pesto in there. I took a taste of this pesto, by the way. And it is such a complex flavor. It is difficult to describe, other than to say it is very good. I'm going to turn the heat off. My sauce is now done. Doesn't that look beautiful? I have another minute to go on my spaghetti, and then I'll be ready to assemble my dish. So here is my cooked spaghetti, cooked al dente. Oh, and I wanted to mention, for those of you who are on the metric system, as far as that shrimp, how much that actually weighs, that was 200 grams by weight, those 16 shrimp. You want to mix your dish now, just to get the pasta coated with that pesto and the oil. And we are ready now to plate this. That looks fantastic. So how I would plate this is put a nice big helping of my spaghetti. That was 1 pound, by the way, of spaghetti that I cooked. 454 grams. Okay, some restaurants like to twist the spaghetti like that, make it pretty. And because I have 16 shrimp, you figure 4 per serving. And there are my shrimp on there. Put a few flakes of my Parmesan on there. And there it is, spaghetti with shrimp and artichoke pesto. The last step, of course, is to see how good that tastes. I'm sure this is going to be so good. I want to taste one of my shrimp first. Not overcooked at all. Tender. And now my spaghetti. My artichoke pesto on it. If I can get enough of this. There we go. Mm. That is very nice. It doesn't have a strong, overpowering flavor, but nonetheless, there's a nice complex flavor there. You can taste the oil, you can taste the cheese, you can taste the artichoke. That is a delicious dish. So excuse me, I'm going to go enjoy my spaghetti with shrimp and artichoke pesto. For a printable PDF copy of this recipe with step-by-step photographs, visit the White Trash Cooking website and look on the homepage or in the recipe archive.